Hi guys, over here to my left, to your right, we have an excellent triangle and we're going to work out the area of it. It is the triangle ABC. Now that internal area is what we're going for. We want the total area. The units are in centimeters. And the first thing we're going to do is write up the formula. Now you remember the formula for the area of a triangle. The area of a triangle is A equals 1/2 times base times height. So what's the base for this one? The base is 8 centimeters. And the height for this one, as you can see, it doesn't have a height. Maybe we'll just measure the height anyway. We'll just measure it. We can't do that because if they haven't given us the height, then clearly we can't use it. So 1/2 times base times height. Actually, I just remembered, and you might notice that that formula is for a what kind of triangle? It's for a right angle triangle, yeah? When you have a right angle triangle, that's got the right angle, 90 degrees, you cannot use that formula for a non-right angle triangle. So this is a non-right angle triangle. We are given an angle and two lengths between it. And this angle's kind of cozy in there. And there's a new formula. And I wonder if I can remember that new formula. It goes something like the area of a non-right angle triangle. Non-right angle, here we are, non-right angle triangle area. I'm gonna give you that formula now. It's a fabulous formula. It's a new tool that we can use to find areas. We don't need that formula. It is area equals 1/2, that looks familiar, AB sine C. So if the angle we're given is C, then the two lengths in between is the angle we go for. In this particular instance, in this particular example, if I was to modify this formula that I just picked out of the book and modified it to suit this particular triangle, the formula would go something like this. It would go as A equals 1/2. Now, we've got to put in the lengths here so we can identify where they are, because the lengths are opposite the capital letters. Remember what we did before? So if we've got a capital B here, then little b is there. If we have a capital A there, which is the angle, then the length across here is little a. And also if we got the angle there, C, the opposite here, the length is going to be little c. So they're all opposites. And if we were to put them in this triangle here, then we would have something like this. It would be 1/2 times. Now, the two ones on the side, as you can see, is the C and the A. So we'll start with A and C. So that'll be A times C times sine. And the angle, which is the capital, right over here, the angle, see that? That's B. So that's our new formula. That's what we're going for. Okay, so let's take the values from here, substitute them in there, and we'll be able to work out the whole area of ABC triangle. So let's do that. So the area would be A equals 1/2 times AC. Here's a little A right there, 8 centimeters. Times little c, which is 7, and then we finish off with sine, the angle that we're given right there. What is that? That is 30 degrees. Excellent. There's our formula all substituted in there. And a rule of thumb to make this nice and short and easy next time you do this is the angle goes right there, whatever angle, and the two sides right between is there and there, the 8 and the 7, yeah? So let's finish this off. So area equals 1/2 times 8 times 7 is 56. And then sine 30 on the calculator is 1/2 or 0.5. So 1/2 times 56 times 1/2. Now 1/2 of 56 is 28. 1/2 of 28 is 14. So the total area right here of the whole triangle ABC . And don't forget the centimeters squared, because it is the area.
Take a minute to check out our website at http://www.vividmaths.com. You'll find additional resources, cheat sheets, transcripts, and other maths videos that are not available on YouTube. Lastly, don't forget to subscribe to get access to all the written answers for your maths questions, plus other special offers.